What do you think, David? Is this provable?
So I said that no, based on the knowledge that we're given here about the mug, a pot, an object, and the things that we know from the past, we can't actually prove that this object is a mug. We can prove that the object is stable and enables drinking based on what we saw with the proof of the cup. The object we're dealing with here had all the same criteria as our object in the other example, in addition to these thick sides and being made of clay. So because we had everything else, we were able to easily prove that it's stable and that it enables drinking. But what we can't do is we can't link protecting against heat to limiting heat transfer. Nothing in my definition of pot actually tells me that the fact that it limits heat transfer actually protects against heat. So while from my definition of pot, I can abstract that because my new object has thick sides and is made of clay, it limits heat transfer, I can't make that last connection to protecting against heat.
That is good, David. Let us make sure that we understand the processing that David did. He wanted to show that the object is a mug. So he looked at the conditions, the open conditions for proving that the object is a mug, and there were three of them. For each of them, he tried to build a proof. He could do so for the first two, but this was the open one. So he came up with the closest example, that was the pot, and he did the abstraction here, but he was unable to link these two because there is no knowledge which links these two at the present time.